It's Jocktober. A celebration of all things shitty in radio.
That's not very nice. Very nice.
Fantastic failures of pontificating proportions.
That's so bad.
Wow.
An interactive exploration of what makes radio rancid.
Jocktober.
OMG.
Hosts, holes, bits, and stunt boys.
This isn't funny.
It's time for Jocktober.
How happy are you? It's time for Jocktober.
Oh, man.
Day three.
Love Jocktober. New God, intro. I love Jocktober.
I like the new intro. Like it a lot. We move on from Syracuse. That was yesterday. And we're going to go up to Maine, huh?
Oh, yeah. To Maine's classic rock.
Ooh. What's
Maine's
their slogan?
Classic rock. It's 107.5 Frank FM.
Frank FM.
And, of course, the show is Stan, Heidi, and Joe.
All right. Do they feed your need for rock?
No, they just...
they don't feed your need for rock.
They don't do that, no.
Really?
Oh, but they do consider themselves Maine's classic rock. What do you see, Ann?
I'm seeing the website
it's
here.
It's the exact same show.
Stan is the seasoned veteran.
He's the seasoned radio veteran.
Heidi's the hole.
Yep.
And, of course, Joe's the gruff guy. Look out, Joe.
Looks a little like Patton Oswalt.
Yeah, a little bit.
But I bet you he's a bit edgy.
Oh,
I bet you he has a tough time getting there in the morning because he's out. He's out at the sports bars.
Yeah.
This is going to be bad.
Oh, no.
Why?
Because on their Facebook page, again, yeah. I think it's a terrible idea for anybody to...
We have never said attack.
No, never. Please don't, as a matter of fact.
Don't do it. Just
never said that.
But they're asking their listeners, what do you think of how she handled this? And it's the video of the fat news lady.
Oh, really?
I mean, that's double trouble, if you ask me.
Oh, they're just asking for people to be rude.
Wow.
Wow. Wow, wow.
They actually posted that?
Yeah. But again, that's not something any of you should do.
So why don't we get right into this today?
Yes.
It's Stan, Heidi, and Joe on Maine's Classic Rock 107.5 Frank FM. Another trend in radio. You go with the first name for your radio station.
Yeah, yeah.
Just that personal touch.
Personal. Hey, I'm listening to Frank.
You feel like you know him a little more.
Yeah, you certainly do.
They gave up on the animals for a while. Now it's first names.
Yeah. The fox.
Yeah. Well, I worked at a couple foxes. Worked at a couple animal stations in my time. We start with Joe's. So Joe's what, the kid, the younger guy?
Yeah.
Okay, just so people know, we start with Joe's dumbass news, and it's called dumbass news.
Nice, yeah, that's edgy.
I don't want anybody to think I'm referring to it as dumbass news.
Of course.
Like, that's what the segment's called.
They call it dumbass news.
Yeah, because Joe's Prep Burger news was, like, you know, too inside, I guess.
You think they're Prep Burgers?
Maybe.
You think they use the Prep Burger?
It's the same show.
They're guilty of using the Prep Burger?
It's day three of Jocktober. We've already fallen in. These are the same shows as each other.
Now, who else uses Prep Burger?
Who?
David Blaine.
Does he?
Yes, he does. That's where he gets his stunts.
A stunt you could do for listener involvement?
Well... We're going to hear Joe's dumbass news as the trio's chemistry flows through the radio.
Yeah. That's the difference maker about this show, that a lot of shows can cover the same things.
Sure.
But it's the chemistry between these three that really sort of...
All right.
It's Joe Lerman's dumbass news. I'm Frank FM.
Well, in Brooksville, Florida, guys, Shahid Mohammed Kalam, I believe that is his name. If not, it is now.
Where's he from?
Yeah. He deposited a $1,000 check. I think he's from Delaware. $1,000 check of a stolen or forged variety.
What? This is the same show.
We already heard
this. So we really don't have to do Jocktober.
There's the guy.
We've kind of done it, right?
Hey, and here's a story. It's like, and now they'll try to riff with it, right? And it just will go nowhere.
You don't think it'll go anywhere?
Oh, never does.
Well, don't be too sure, Mr. Know-it-all.
Who's the pig?
Eric. Jesus.
Sorry, he's shaking his head.
He's just sitting there.
He's not even listening.
Poor guy.
Does he know what we're talking about?
Yeah, I wouldn't think so.
He's either downloading bikini pictures.
He loves bikini girls.
Writing fan fiction.
WWE fan fiction.
Right. Or memoirs of his time spent as a youth in school in Florida.
Or I've heard he's writing a book about working for Scott Shannon.
Oh, yeah, really?
I've heard it.
That'll be a page turner.
Yeah.
$1,000 check of a stolen or forged variety at 3 a.m. at a local credit union and then attempted to withdraw the cash from an ATM. Unfortunately for Shahid, the ATM card he used was expired and he was using the wrong PIN code.
Oh, no.
Yikes. The machine swallowed the card, prompting Shahid to back his vehicle up into the ATM machine, tie a seatbelt to it, and attempt to rip it off the wall. That always goes well. When that predictably failed, Shahid used a stolen handgun to fire a bullet through the front door, shattering the glass. Yes, the ATM surveillance camera captured the comedy of errors, and Shahid was busted when he returned to the credit union for unrelated business.
Holy fuck, I'm exhausted.
What other business do you have at the credit
union?
You don't have a valid card. You don't have a valid account. You don't have anything. There is no business at the credit union.
Probably was trying to make a withdrawal.
Yeah, probably.
Wow. Holy shit, that was exhausting.
The radio voice is what drives me crazy.
Yeah. And he was trying to make a withdrawal.
Yeah. But he sounds like Pat Oswalt, too. He sounds like him, yes. I've seen Ratatouille enough to know, trust me.
True. Okay.
Oh, my God. Move on to another movie, kid.
Sure.
But you guys don't like how the bit kind of crescendoed?
Crescendoed?
Yeah. There's a nice little fucking zinger at the end.
Yeah, with,
that would be probably. The out.
Frank Evans.
Tom Papa joins us as we're doing Jocktober. Did they tell you what
good
we're
morning.
Doing?
Good morning.
Have you been here for Jocktober yet?
I have never been here for Jocktober.
Welcome. You might not want to be here for Jocktober.
Welcome to Bridge Burners 101 for comics.
Now you see one day of a month, and what I have to fucking navigate as I go on the road.
Oh, no.
I realize, we attacked this show.
Yeah, you play anywhere in Maine? You play anywhere up in Maine? Because that's
Portland,
where we are.
Portland, Oregon,
for that matter. This is a show in Maine, I guess.
You've done some of these radio shows, huh, Tom?
Oh yeah, we've got painters' caps this morning. We're bringing little Jimmy Norton. He's kind of crazy.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's it. I've been him.
It's awful
all the time.
Why do they do that?
They're trying to muster up some energy.
They hate their lives.
Because, yeah.
All right, we're going to move on. It's Stan, Heidi, and Joe on Maine's Classic Rock, 107.5 Frank FM.
That's right.
So was that it with the dumb ass news?
Yeah, I mean, I thought, yeah, that's...
The chemistry was pretty good, though.
And the great punchline at the end is delivered, and they move on to the next story.
It's just... A story about a woman with her kid in the trunk of her car. Don't worry, Heidi brings the funny.
Leave it to Heidi.
Oh, she's still a little nutty.
You can tell already, right?
Yeah, it's Heidi. It's really kind of unpredictable.
When Washington State Patrol troopers pulled over Ann Boyle for speeding, they noticed that she seemed a bit nervous. Now, it could have been because she had, speed, heroin, pills, and drug paraphernalia in her car. Or maybe it was just the marijuana aroma that was billowing from the vehicle. When the trooper inquired about the smell, Anna admitted that she took a few hits earlier. As officers were searching the vehicle, they heard a thumping sound coming from the trunk, which turned out to be Anna's 8-year-old daughter, her two sons, ages 7 and 5, and a small dog. Child Protective Services took the kids into custody, and police took Anna and her fiancé into custody as well.
Why would you put three kids and a dog in the trunk?
Whatever. Well, I mean, listen.
God.
And she's, hey, by the way.
Oh, wow.
The chemistry is amazing.
The wit.
Yeah. Well, and now we welcome Amy Schumer. The lovely Amy Schumer.
We're in the middle of Jocktober.
Yes.
Have you been here for Jocktober, Amy?
I have not.
Oh, do you play any places in Maine?
No.
Because we're totally wiping one radio station off the map for any comics
that is associated with this show.
Yeah.
Even guys that aren't here will feel their wrath.
Yes.
And we're focusing on this show today, and there's two guys and the hole.
Is this these are the people?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the pig is the hole.
Amy, you might this might sound familiar to you when we did the Louis thing.
Oh, is
it's
are they
exactly
the real deal?
Like that.
Yeah.
It's
whatever.
Yeah. It's I just see terrible. No reason for those people to be alive.
Yes. That's exactly why we do
until
this.
Until you have to sell tickets in Maine.
There's zero demand for me in Maine.
We're looking at the Stan, Heidi, and Joe show on Maine's Classic Rock 107.5 Frank FM. They go over a list of ways to remember things.
Oh, boy. Oh.
As if people can't just write a list.
Ooh. That's helpful.
I put a pin in my clit.
It sounds very helpful. It's good.
Okay. This is helpful, guys.
Three ways to remember everything or anything that you need to. Number one, this is the first tip. Look, snap, and connect, the experts say. This three-step method helps you create meaning, which leads to faster and more accurate remembering.
Look, snap, and what?
I don't know.
Lip.
I wasn't listening. I forgot how to remember.
Yeah, look, terrible. Snap, and point. What is that?
Like look, snap, connect. Remember? Connect.
Connect.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Nice. I got a gold star.
So how do I look, snap?
No, connect.
Wait, connect.
Look, snap, connect, or look, connect, snap?
Look, snap, connect.
Look, snap, connect.
Guys, if you just pay attention, you'll figure it out.
Yeah. Look, snap, connect.
I never remember a thing.
You girls.
I swear. Well, tits weren't sewed on. I'd leave them at home.
Just like my wife.
Now, Amy.
All right, look, snap, connect.
So more
if I see a girl that I fucked, I have to point and go, man.
Faster and more accurate remembrance.
The puker.
Hang on.
Yeah.
I'm looking at you, Heidi, right now.
Here's an example.
See, that's what I'm thinking. I'm like, if I was just meeting you, I would look at you and say, your name is Stan. Okay, Stan. And I'd snap and point at you.
Yeah. Well, here's an example, guys. Ooh. This is how it works.
Okay. Here's an example, guys.
This is horrible.
Here's why. He couldn't get to his example. Like, they're trying to joke with him, and he's the example kid. He wants to get back on track to the example.
The example kid.
While fucking that lady, while fucking Frances McDormand from Fargo is trying to fucking improv a little shit. Yeah,
the monster is trying to get a joke in there. Give her credit for that.
Who does her hairdo look like? That fucking British hairdo.
Cindy Lou who? Cindy Lou Jew. They almost look like Pais.
She almost has Pais coming down.
Yeah.
It's sort of a...
She has hair like Herb Tarlick from fucking WKRP in Cincinnati.
Oh, it works.
Okay.
If you have to buy, you go out to the store and you got to buy eggs, you got to buy stamps, and you have to buy shoes in one trip. Eggs, stamps, and shoes, okay? And you want to hit all three. Imagine yourself.
I know how you remember it. Oh. You put those three together. Eggs, stamps, and shoes. My wife wants to have kids, so I don't. So I should put on my shoes, kick her in the eggs, and then stamp on her pussy. Done.
I'm not sure that's what they meant.
Oh, God.
I'm probably mistaken.
Imagine yourself holding a large egg with a stamp on it, and then watch the egg slip from your hands and break all over your shoe.
Right.
Oh.
So you've the egg, the stamp on it,
right,
and then the shoes.
And then
it's
you look
down
and you're like,
and getting
wait, what was I trying to remember? And you're like going through like fucking peep booth memories. And you're like, no, that's not how I got the heck out of my shoe. Oh, that's right, it was the egg. Because it looks like cum with yellow stuff in it, which would be hepatitis.
On it,
right,
and then the shoes that it's falling down and getting all over.
Well, you're used to having an egg in your hand, right?
What?
I don't know what it means, but it's crazy.
What the fuck did that mean? Well, actually, two eggs, and they're usually in an oniony smelling bag while I'm smoking a fleshy pipe.
What the fuck just happened?
I don't know.
What happened?
We just took a year off our lives.
Can we go to the end again?
Yeah. I listen to that clip a lot of times.
What happened?
I don't know.
The music in the bed.
And then
awful music
the
bed.
Shoes that it's falling down and getting all over.
Well, you're used to having an egg in your hand, right?
Can we call and ask?
No,
can we call? Let's call and ask.
I think I know what it is.
For real?
Yeah. I think this guy has cancer. And the guy is making fun of the fact that he's always handling his tumor.
Yeah, that's it.
That's by the way, that's it.
We've already hit phase three.
Phase three?
This phase is... You guys have no idea what this
is. Sam, you got to get to the computer real
quick. You got
to
reach over Amy.
Yeah, let's
reach around.
Yeah, reach around.
Give her the reach around.
Stupid. I'm hoping nobody, because a lot of times the fans, we don't want them to do
five
this.
5 billion hits.
Wow, we went from phase one, phase, I mean, wow.
They go to the quickly. Facebook page, and they're kind of aggressive with it.
Oh, they, oh no.
Their fans?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's their fans, because we didn't tell our fans to go there. We would never say that, because that would be not nice.
That's not nice.
Oh, boy.
Yes.
Wait, is that the same people in this picture?
Yeah.
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 That's the same girl?
Yep.
Yeah, that pig is.
Yeah. They've started blocking people. They've closed down their wall for right. public people.
So we didn't get to normal, see anything yet.
The normal.
Fuck. Well, I mean, like, good morning. We'll see what the comments are on good morning. Do you want to check?
That's, yeah.
Where's the... Where's the
okay. Let's check. Cause we,
good morning. Oh, wow.
Oh, no. Oh,
wow.
No.
Wow.
Kinds
of,
oh, no. Wow.
Why, Sam, I believe that's the N-word.
Yeah.
Welcome to Maine.
There's a picture of Sam next to it.
Somebody asks, is Stan the cuckold? Look, you fat fuck, snap out of your fat streak and connect the gun to your skull.
Jesus.
I can't believe their fans
phase
are doing
three
this.
Is violent.
Yeah, it does get very violent, yes.
Wow. Resistance is futile, shit dicks. Phase three. Tom, Stan looks like a bull prepper.
Phase four, they make believe they never had a Facebook page.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they just take it offline. Take it offline.
Oh, no.
I mean, this one, amazing. I don't even understand. It says good morning, and the response is AIDS mouth.
Yeah. Doesn't even add up.
But what is a bull prepper? Why would they say that one of them looks like a bull prepper?
A bull prepper.
That's amazing.
God.
Wow. I mean, now they're talking about Heidi's vagina.
Oh, guys.
We don't need that.
That's awful.
That's terrible.
I can't and believe this is that type of show.
Why don't you refresh? Refresh.
Okay, let me refresh.
We might be in phase four.
No, we're still in phase three.
Oh, okay.
Stone phase three.
Oh, I got wrong information. I'm sorry.
Does it happen that quickly? Like phase four will happen right before our eyes?
It'll happen. Yeah.
They deleted the posted video, by the way, too. Remember?
Oh, we didn't even see what they said. There was a video
the
of that fat reporter, yeah.
That's right, yeah.
They deleted that video because I guess they asked people to comment on it. I guess they didn't appreciate
the comments. Do you think the comments were unkind?
No.
Very supportive.
Yeah, a lot of times they'll put really tasteless pictures up, which I don't
know. Yeah, we don't condone any of this.
Nope.
That's terrible.
Never said to do
I do laugh at it, though. But
of course.
No. Their chemistry is amazing, though.
It's really
that
good.
Back and forth, the funny, witty little thing, the egg. You go usually have an egg in your hand.
I don't want to interrupt. Phase four has been achieved. Their Facebook page is gone.
No. It just happened.
Three for three.
Unbelievable.
It just happened.
Unbelievable.
Wow, this is the quickest, I think.
Yeah, I think we only got the three clips.
We've only done about 10 minutes
of action.
We've only done 10 minutes of Jocktober.
Nope.
Phase four.
We are fucking assholes.
We will never.
Just assholes.
We will never go to Maine.
No, it's done.
I hope you guys get
lost. What are you, a bunch of lobsters?
I don't know.
Why don't we should we play another clip?
Fucking shit, man.
Yeah, I guess.
I think Jimmy sits there in the chip face for 2 minutes after he says something.
Relishing it.
like his own fart.
Let's do another clip from Stan, Heidi, and Joe on Maine's Classic Rock, 107.5 Frank FM. A way to remember what song you're listening to, they get into.
Yeah. They even reference, if you have a smartphone, this is what you can do.
Does it involve an egg?
No eggs. I hope so.
Yeah. Don't we have apps for that now?
With Shazam.
Shazam? Of course. We all know about Shazam.
Shazam. What are they talking about? They don't know, Opie.
It's Maine. I don't know what they have up there.
Tip of the tongue. You know who's jamming on the radio? You know what band is jamming on the radio.
Jamming
on the radio.
He said it twice to make sure everybody
knows. What band is jamming on the radio?
I mean, everyone else says rocking. I say jamming.
I'm a hep cat.
Even Cousin Bruce, he's like, that term isn't used anymore.
Jamming. Let me tell you, 23 Skidoo, I know about jamming.
Anyone have an example of a song that jams?
Hubba Hubba.
Anything by Fish.
Raindrops keep falling on your head.
Yeah, that's a good jam.
We built the city on rock and roll.
Yes.
Amy Schumer.
Right.
We built the city.
That's a great jam.
That's been your go-to lately.
I love it. Well, who did I play that to?
Joe DeRosa. He's wearing a denim jacket.
Oh,
you said, this is your soundtrack.
I kept playing it. Just the beginning.
I love it. A lot of abuse for his clothes.
Oh, clothes.
Anything to cover those tattoos.
Yeah. Someone called him Steve Austin or what's it? $6 million man. Lee Majors,
Bill Burr.
Bill Burr called him Lee Majors.
He trashed him.
Hey, Lee Majors. Jesus, Joe.
Although That's not the version of the song that is the better version.
Oh, what? Well, we know. Yeah, there is. Oh, I remember. My dick's all shitty.
And that will get stuck in your head.
This guy sells it, though.
It sounds like kids are singing
it. Listen to the guy sell the song, though, man. He's all in.
Oh, yes.
This will be in my head for a fucking month now. Oh, no. Never leaves.
Really?
Never.
It's your fantasy.
Ten, ten. Say you won't blow me. Oh, God. Got it, got it.
Is this Voss?
Oh. I like the subtlety of it.
Yeah.
I don't know where he's going yet.
You're really going to think it over. Duty on my dick, really? Because it's brown.
Small. Like harmony.
You're coolie.
Bring it home, buddy.
Yeah.
I picture him in a headband.
Oh, guys.
Come on, Tom.
Is he jamming right now?
He's jamming.
He's jamming.
My dick's all shitty.
By the way, Amy, a lot of people offering you a ride home today.
Oh, thank you. How nice.
Boy. Let's get back to this, I don't know, how to remember a song bit they're doing.
Yeah, jamming.
Tip of the tongue. You know who's jamming on the radio? You know what band is jamming on the radio, but the name is escaping you. You're like, oh my God, I used to love that band, and you're hearing something on Frank, and you go, but I just can't remember what the name is.
You're hearing something on Frank.
Grab your smartphone or a piece of paper and jot down.
It's the Frank.
Frank.
It's Frank.
Frank.
So, of course, you're listening to Frank. You're not listening to some other station.
Right. You want your band.
Yeah. The multitude of other places you can get your music.
Or your fucking iPod.
Yeah. Oh, God. Yeah.
You don't have to sell the station you're on all the time.
Yeah. We're on a first name basis.
But then again, they're being very helpful here.
I bet the program director was like, I really liked how you got the station in there. That was a great choice you made.
It sounded very natural.
Yeah, yeah. We need more of that.
Guys, I hate to interrupt, but how do you remember these songs?
I don't know. That's why we're playing this, Tom.
You grab your smartphone. So far, all I have is you grab your smartphone.
Yeah.
And hopefully you and you scroll to one of your cock photos and you show the gal in the seat next to you. And you say, what song is this?
You go, but I just can't remember what the name is. Grab your smartphone or a piece of paper and jot down all the clues you're using to figure out the name.
Grab your kite or your F-15 fighter jet. A smartphone or a piece of paper. Yeah. That's brilliant.
Jot down the clues.
What the fuck is that? Yeah.
Jot down the clues.
Grab this rock or this nuclear missile.
When was the last time you jotted down clues?
Never.
When you're figuring
right.
There's a beat.
Yes. The chorus.
He sounds African-American.
Oh, God.
Have your smartphone or a piece of paper and jot down all the clues
you're
using.
And the last thing you see the guy write down is wall.
Paper and jot down all the clues you're using to figure out the name, including specific lyrics of the song, the year you think it was released, or the name of the
look. If you don't
the
know the
year,
thanks, Tom. If you don't know the song, you're not going to remember the year.
Well, how about get a friend, cocksucker, and go, "What's that song that goes?" Then he'll tell you.
What the fuck? That's exhausting.
Get another friend who jots.
Yeah. I think most radio stations now show you what's being played, right?
Even on regular radio.
Yes,
they do, right? Jot that down.
Jot down your jam.
Yeah.
The year you think it was released, or the name of the radio station,
which of course is going to be Frank FM. The name of the backup musicians, the studio bass player, what type of strings he used on the guitar. What the fuck? This guy's making it much too complicated.
This is a bit, Sam. Where's the twist?
Yeah.
There is no twist.
We're like, he's fucking with us.
Heidi even tries a little bit to give it a twist.
The moose?
But he's like, no.
Oh, boy. It is Maine. Yeah, it is Maine.
That was endearing.
Yeah, was,
they love
wow.
Of the radio reference. Station, which of course is going to be Frank FM. Tip of the tongue experiences are from your memory that's already in there. You just haven't retrieved it for a while.
Right.
You do know who that band is. You just can't find it in, as Stan would call it, his filing cabinet.
Yeah, I got a filing cabinet.
That you've got in your
there.
Head. That's all. When you see things sometimes on paper, it will come to you.
Which means
what's going on? Holy shit.
They've talked about it so often.
Do you know how many times he's bored people at parties with this discussion? You actually do know the name of the song.
I call my filing cabinet.
All you're thinking is,
it's my filing cabinet.
Drive drunk and get killed. That's all you're thinking.
I'd just be like, yeah, I'm going to go grab a drink. I'll be right back, though.
Yeah.
Hold that place.
Everyone leaves.
Yeah, everyone leaves this guy at the party. You will look at him awkwardly. Sipping his beverage, looking around the room at everyone who's left him.
And he's getting drunk thinking, fuck these motherfuckers.
Yeah. The whole room looks like a daisy cutter was dropped on him. Just fucking people spread away from him as far away as possible.
Oh, God.
It's my when you see things sometimes on paper, it will come to you a little bit quicker than just trying to think of it off the top of your head.
You know,
that makes sense to me.
Yeah, you know, no matter what I have to do, because I have to remember a lot of things, I always do the alphabet game. Do you do the alphabet game?
I do this when I try to think of an actress.
Who stole
or...
that? N?
This can't be real.
It can't be real.
I think it's real.
It's the realest ever.
Alphabet game. I do this when I try to think of an actress or an actor.
Does Al Sharpton have AIDS?
Reverend Al looks like a shrunken head.
Oh, I hope he's
now,
sick.
He really doesn't look good.
He fucking got that lap band, obviously.
Oh, did he?
What?
He must have.
He did.
Reverend Al is so...
Thank you.
He's skinny now. He's 58 today.
Oh, is he?
Not that anyone cares, but...
What a guy.
Maybe he's doing another hunger strike where...
It's like they made an Al Sharpton doll out of leftover skin from Al Roker.
Oh, he does. God.
Tom Papa will be at the Improv in Washington, D.C. tomorrow through Saturday.
Nice.
Yeah.
And Tom Papa on Twitter.
I try to think of an actress or an actor.
Absolutely. I go, A,
yes.
B, no, C, D. No. E,
and it
F,
will trigger
C.
In me.
Oh, yeah.
You know, yeah, you'll think of the first or last name. You'll get to the K's and you go, Kate! Yeah. That's who that woman is. Her name is Kate, blah, blah, blah. You don't do that?
No.
Blah, blah, blah. I do that.
Really?
I do that for songs. I do that for actors. I do that for movies.
People's names.
And it does work. Oh.
Absolutely work.
You're standing over your girlfriend going, what am I going to do right now? A, B, C, right, come in your face.
Does this belong on a morning radio show?
This is some of
this
the
is
most...
like that self-help shit.
Boring drivel.
Who
there's cassettes
this?
For this stuff.
Who's the audience? Who's the audience?
You know what? It's
every Frank's audience.
Mom. Just, I said
elderly
the other day.
Elderly mom who thinks that these are kids. Do you hear the kids this morning?
I said the other day that the audience is from Fargo, Jean Lundegaard, the wife that got kidnapped, who's sitting there watching that morning show and laughing. like watching Brainerd today.
Right. In her mom jeans.
And she's just like, oh, that's a good one. That's funny. That's exactly the audience.
And eating dinner later that night. Have you heard about the file cabinet?
Yeah. Oh, she repeats the things that they said. You know, I got a handy way to remember things. Yeah, I heard a funny egg joke.
I'm going to the Costco. The people from the station are going to be there this morning.
Oh, God.
They're signing mugs.
You know, just putting a face to a name. It's fantastic.
Long time listener.
Yeah.
Oh, she's skinnier than I thought.
Oh, yeah.
You'll never hear that. Wow, she's morbidly obese. She doesn't sound such a fat pig. That's what
I didn't know you're so close to dying.
This is getting Irish, you guys. You're a moose.
Should we continue with this?
Please.
Or
yes.
Have we heard enough?
I have to know.
Really?
Yes.
All right. Another news story. This one is fun for the whole family.
This clip illustrates exactly what you just brought up. Like, you try to figure out who is enjoying this. Like, why would you do this?
Oh.
You tell me if you think this is appropriate for, like, a fun, you know, upbeat morning show.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fun for the whole family.
Right.
All right. Watch it start off. Andrea Yates.
Here's the deal. A Connecticut man... shot dead a masked man he believed was trying to break into his sister's home. Now, his sister lives next door to him.
Mm-hmm.
So his sister basically called him up and said, I think somebody's breaking in. There's somebody outside the house.
Right.
So he runs over, gets into the house, and as the person is breaking into the house, he notices they're dressed in black, mm-hmm. have a ski mask on, and a gun. So what does the guy do?
Shoots him.
Shoots him dead.
Mm-hmm.
Takes the mask off. It's his son.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
That's oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
And now what here's a Steely Dan.
Are we jamming to that song? I think we're jamming to that song.
Yes. You get all the clues.
Yes.
Amy Schumer is going to be in Pittsburgh.
Very good.
Pittsburgh Saturday and Poughkeepsie on Friday.
Nice. Oh, you got a couple plugs going on here.
Oh, yeah.
It's a little confusing here, I think. Nice. Friday in Poughkeepsie at the Bardavon Theater. Is that how you say that?
Sure.
Yeah.
And then Rex Theater in Pittsburgh on Saturday.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, hitting my two favorite cities same weekend.
Nice.
Lucky you.
Put this city on Amy Schumer. Come
on. Oh, wow. It's going to be in my head forever.
Sam, that was, they didn't have anything after that, huh?
Well, they did.
Oh,
that was a little bit of a downer, but you can always count on Heidi. What she does is she takes that story, and she's actually got a personal experience that it's just completely the same thing. It relates. Yeah, it relates entirely.
Well, you got to do that on the radio.
Thank God.
You got to relate to some of this shit.
She lets everybody know she's had to deal with stuff like that as well.
Oh, yeah. All right.
I just can't
and
imagine
what
this guy's going to go through the rest of his life.
Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, it's
sad story.
You're suffering enough there. But I've known people that have, you know, you back over the family dog that's running around.
Yeah,
that happens all the time.
Scared to death.
And the guilt, you got to live with that.
I backed over the lawnmower once.
Yeah,
my husband parked his brand new John Deere right behind my car.
Oh, it was a John Deere?
Yeah.
You can't run over a John Deere.
I didn't know that he parked it there, so I backed up and kind of ran over the front end a little bit.
That's not quite the same as murdering your own son with a handgun.
You stupid bitch. Yeah, that's a bit of a drop-off as far as trying to relate to the story.
She has nothing to add. One time I remember I burned the steak.
Yes.
He killed his son.
Yeah.
Yeah, really.
And equate it to
your lawnmower with
it was
bumper.
A John Deere, though.
Yeah.
And run over a John Deere?
I didn't know that he parked it there, so I backed up and kind of ran over the front end a little bit and then pulled forward and thought, what was that?
And she's got to live with that every day.
I know.
Wow.
Yeah.
Every day.
Boy.
Do you think that father is listening to this show right now, being like, at least somebody knows where I'm coming
from? Understand my pain.
She's been through it.
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
And I didn't even know it was his lawnmower until he pulled the ski mask off and realized that it was.
Stupid fatso.
Are we done now?
Well, I mean,
what?
You know, it's Frank FM.
Yeah, but we got some funny people in the studio.
What phase are we still in?
I didn't know if you guys wanted to hear the frankly impossible question of the day.
Frank. Oh, God.
Of course.
Frank, because the station is Frank. They have the
they
frankly.
They don't do that.
Yeah,
they have to work in that Frank as much
do they
as
have
possible.
Frank speak,
I think
like,
the question of the day is who married that Sasquatch?
Do they give away like Franks?
Yeah.
Is that what they do? I bet the Frank is all over
that. You think that's pretty popular?
Yeah.
Frank giveaways?
Frank's
I don't like that station. Oh, Frank was better.
Oh, Frank was better.
We looked at a show yesterday. They gave away for their impossible question. I think, well, whatever. They had some kind of trivia. They gave away dinner at a, what was it?
Ichiban.
Ichiban.
Right.
Nice, right?
Yeah.
Sure.
But you can only go on a Wednesday.
That's hilarious.
Like they said you could use this, but you could only use it on a Wednesday.
I love it.
A Wednesday night.
I like their other promotion. They're giving away beer mugs, actually.
Oh.
Yeah, with African Americans on them. And they call them the Frankenstein. Oh, boy.
Hello.
Oh, boy.
Frankenstein.
See, because it's a racist joke, kids. Very racist.
Frankly, I'm offended.
Yeah.
I get it.
All right, why don't we do this, Sam? What is it again?
Frankly impossible
Frankly
question.
Frankly impossible question, Jimmy.
HarvestHillFarms.com, or you can win a pair of tickets right now. Just answer this impossible question.
All right, here it is. USA Today says, if you play this game, you'll likely live 4.5 years longer than people
who
don't
play
this game.
I know what it is. I know the game.
Cutting your dick off.
Come on.
How do you know?
Turkey foot.
No.
That doesn't make sense.
Terrible.
Sure it does.
If you play, so it says Monster Rain. You can't play Monster Rain.
If you play this game, you live 4 years longer.
Longer.
What?
I guess Russian roulette's out of the question.
I was just thinking.
Come on, that's crazy.
I'm going to guess it's
for a show like this, that would be a good line.
Well,
you know, but you think they
yeah. Oh, yeah, that's
what,
crazy.
What, Sam? Sam?
You guys asked, I think Tom just asked what phase we were in. We thought phase four was the end.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just getting an update because we have people listening.
Oh, yeah.
And,
oh, no.
Since the Facebook was taken down, they have not gone live on the air whatsoever. It's been only music production and commercials.
Oh my God.
Nobody is picking up the request.
Oh, no.
Oh, that conference room is smoking.
Oh, yeah.
The donuts
oh, yeah.
are cleared off the table.
Oh, no.
There's right, a PowerPoint look. Presentation.
Why are we affecting their show?
We've been attacked. This is terrible.
What happened?
I mean, I will offer some radio play, but this is just...
You know, a good-natured ribbing of each other's shows is fine, but this has just gone too far.
They should just goof on it.
Oh, why would they?
No, that would not be good.
I need someone get me a shoe, a stamp, and an egg. I'm going to war.
Snap.
4.5 years longer than people who don't play this game. What is it?
Oh, can I take a guess?
Yeah, you can.
Cribbage.
No, it's not that. USA.
What a terrible guess. I would never get, even if you said, what card game rhymes with Bibbage? I wouldn't say that.
Yucky.
That's where she should have said Russian roulette.
Oh, or, hey, what's the best edge to stick your cock in?
What?
Oh, God. Yay.
Oh,
can I take a guess?
Yeah, you can.
Cribbage.
No, it's not that. USA Today says that if you play this game, you'll likely live about 4.5 years longer than the people who don't play it. What is it?
How about poker?
No. I didn't even know her.
Back in 2 minutes. Hang on.
That's a closer. You know a closer when you know a closer.
I was feeling a little bad. I was feeling a little guilty when Sam just said that. And then now I feel great. I feel wonderful.
That would have taken us out fucking from
high
chip.
High fives around the room.
He felt very good about his quickness there.
Yeah.
As soon as the first starts running, you know we weren't going to top that.
Yeah.
Let's,
if there's a God, they're having a meeting right now where they're all into a suicide pact.
Poker in the front, liquor in the rear.
No, if there's a God, the meeting opened like this. Look, they're right.
Want to hear that again?
Let's hear that out. Live about 4.5 years longer than the people who don't play it. What is it?
How about poker?
No. I didn't even know her.
Back in 2 minutes. Hang on.
Oh, you know, because it's all fun.
Because it's all fun. It's all fun.
Very casual. Hang on. Doesn't go anywhere.
Back in 2 minutes, because he walks over to her and just starts hitting her. You don't laugh at what I'm saying.
Back in 2 minutes.
Really? Back
in 2 minutes. Yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah. All right.
And he pushes the mic away.
Yeah, yeah.
I wish you left the sweeper in there because you know it came in strong.
Oh, Frank Evans.
Oh, God.
Wow.
That's it, I guess?
That was a doozy.
That was physically painful.
Yeah, it really was. My stomach's still tight.
Oh, we got another communique. Why doesn't E-Rock just read the communiques? Why do you hand them to Sam?
Oh, wow.
What happened?
They were in the middle of a contest. This is from listeners in Maine. And they just started running a segment from last year without announcing what happened in the contest. They're finished. They're done for
the
day.
They were in the middle of a contest when they shut down everything?
There's no result to the contest.
What was the contest?
That I don't know.
Least entertaining radio show?
A moose ride. You win a moose ride on the host.
Wow. Death Con 4.
Their show, their actual... We just thought that Facebook gets shut down. Their actual show.
Is this a first?
Is this the first?
Which is why are they shutting the show down? What the fuck's wrong with people? It's babies.
This means phone calls from them to
this is crazy.
To those dopes down the hall.
Oh, yeah.
Guess what? We're not shutting down Jocktober. Shut up. That's exactly what we're trying to do.
Oh, boy.
I love Jocktober.
Oh, boy.
Ooh. What if it gets us out of all morning press from now on?
Yeah.
On the road?
So, we'll have to do anything tomorrow.
You're like, look, I'd love to do it, but they said no.
So they go to the phones to get the answer to that question, I guess?
Well, yeah, of course. And we can't leave the listeners on a cliffhanger like that.
I want to hear,
Dan, Heidi, and Joe, what's your guess?
Scrabble?
Scrabble. Nope, that's not it.
I want you to guess.
Good guess,
though. How about chess?
Chess.
Nope, not that.
These are all good games. Yeah. Say, Heidi and Joe Show, what you guess?
Is it Angry Birds?
No, that's not it. Stan, Heidi, and Joe Show, what's your guess?
Solitaire.
Solitaire. No, that is not it.
Well, hello, what's your guess?
It's golf.
Golf.
You know, how do you know it's golf?
I know it's golf because I play golf a lot. I've heard this before.
Well, USA Today says that if you play this game, you're likely to live 4.5 years longer than people who don't. The answer is, indeed, golf.
Very nice. I don't agree with that. I'm usually hammered when I'm playing golf.
That's wild.
All right, Stan, Heidi, and Joe Show, congratulations.
Thanks.
Ooh.
Yeah.
They're jamming right there.
Little fucking
Def Leppard, right?
Def Leppard, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
And we learned
that's
something.
A jamming song.
Yeah. Wow. That was really fascinating radio.
Yeah.
Really was amazing. Oh, God.
And, of course, they announced the Frankly Impossible question. They looked it up in USA Today. So anybody who had a USA Today could have found the Frankly impossible answer.
Yeah, it's not Frankly Impossible.
It's not really impossible.
No, you just need to get USA Today.
Everybody checking out of a Days Inn in Maine.
Well, there you go. Jocktober for today.
Enjoying the continental breakfast.
Over.
You want another update?
Wow.
Another update. Yes, you are.
All right. From people calling in, the contest that they were doing was wrestler nicknames. Went right to music, and the bit they're playing now is about a cancer benefit from last year.
Maybe that ties in with the wrestler nicknames. Oh, no, it's Lumpito.
Lumpito.
Old Puddinhead McGillicuddy.
Oh, no, it's Sad Tired Man.
Wow. So they battened down the hatches here. They went to the mattresses.
Why? Yeah. They
for
could
what?
Just do their show without taking phone calls.
We're not even going after their live show.
We're not
show.
Going after their show. Why would they panic like this?
We're not calling their
oh,
show.
Oh, you think they were... Oh,
maybe they're just humiliated. They are panicking.
They were panicking that we were going to go after their actual show.
We're not.
Kids are fuck.
We're not calling your show.
Yeah, by tomorrow we won't even remember you.
No.
That was a good Jocktober, Sam.
You enjoyed it?
Wow.
Yeah.
Who's tomorrow?
That was a delight.
I don't know who tomorrow is.
Is it time for Terry Clifford?
Unfucking.
You're really... I didn't...
What?
Unfucking believable, that show.
It really
and the fact that they're going crazy over there now because the Facebook page.
Because of us?
We'll be back in two.
Yeah,
we'll be back in two. Sticker.
You got to be proud, though, you know.
Oh, boy.
Sit back.
Yeah, look at I did.
High fives around the room with that break. That was a good one.
What's weird is it just came off the top of my head.
You know, let me tell you.
I wasn't even planning it.
How do you do it?
Oh, God.
You think the PD poked his head in? Good job, guys. Good job.
Oh, he pokes his head in and he goes, that's why you make the big bucks.
That's what I was talking about in our air check meeting.
Yeah, he still air checks. They got to bring in, like, the show on a tape, and they go over it with the PD. That was good, what you did there. I like that.
See, that's what I was getting
putting
at.
In Frank. Just mention
during
Frank
our last meeting.
As many times you want.
You worked in the Frank thing perfectly.
Look at Frank as a friend of ours. He's a fourth jock.
Frank, the station should be a fourth jock.
Oh,
it's a person. It's a personality.
He's your imaginary
friend. You want the
friend.
Listeners to think of Frank as their friend.
My wife was saying in the car the other day, she actually sees Frank in her head.
Yes.
We were going to go to break, but Sam comes running in and says, don't go to break.
Yeah.
And then he handed me a disc. I don't even know what this is
about. Thanks fully to our listeners and not our worthless interns.
Oh, man.
Can't do a thing.
Right. And they suck.
Yeah, they're terrible. But thankfully, our listeners have half a brain at least.
Uh-huh.
Our show on Frank FM that we were just talking about, they did make an announcement about somebody...
What?
Hacking.
What?
Somebody hacked their Facebook.
Maybe that's what happened.
Yeah. Maybe it got
hacked.
Good,
they can't blame us. Maybe someone hacked their Facebook.
What do you
Facebook?
Mean, they said it on air?
They went on the air. That's the audio.
Oh really?
Yeah. Oh, boy. Right. I love interactive radio. This is fun.
No, is this a new phase?
Yeah, new phase, definitely.
Our Facebook page.
Mm.
So, Well, behind the scenes here at Frank FM, we don't know what is going on, but it looks like somebody has hacked into our Facebook page, and they've been posting very, what would you say?
Graphic and
very
disturbing
graphic
photos,
No, those are the ones you put up.
Yeah, that's just your profile picture. Yeah.
You know what? Maybe that's what happened.
Maybe that's what happened. You're right.
Maybe that's what maybe one of their fans hacked the Facebook page.
Could happen. Could happen.
We didn't tell anyone to do this.
No. Very, what would you say?
Graphic and
very
disturbing
graphic
photos, yeah.
And disturbing photos. So if
and I don't want anybody seeing them. So is there a way we can just block this or take it off?
Yeah, I think that what we're going to end up having
certainly
to do
don't want to bring
is
attention to it and have everybody go to it right now.
Yeah.
Because it's
yeah
not a good time.
No. So we're
something's
basically
going on.
Yeah, we're basically going to shut down our Facebook page
for right
so
now.
That this doesn't continue. And I have no idea who does
we've
this
been hacked.
We have been
upsetting tens of listeners.
All right, we're going to be giving away big time wrestling passes right now.
That's right. It's a pair.
They're my God. They know exactly who did it, by the way.
Exactly.
And the PD came running in and said, you make an announcement.
You've got to make an announcement. People are wondering what's happening here at Frank.
We have no idea who's involved.
I want to talk to Frank.
Where's Frank?
Frankly, this is out of control.
Oh. Bring up the calls again like you did. Here at Frank FM.
She's crying in the conference room. I just feel bad for Frank. He doesn't deserve this.
It's a station, you dummy. All right.
Friend.
All right.
Wow. This
amazing
is exciting.
It's interactive. It's good. You do something, you get a response.
Right.
Yeah.
In Maine.
Yeah, in Maine. It's quite great amazing.
It
this
feeds our
day
egos.
Age
we like that.
We're living in great times, bros.
Yeah. We'll have another show tomorrow. We're going to move on from these idiots.
Yeah, we're done with them now.
Can you give me a hint? What's tomorrow?
I mean, I have a couple options to go to, but I want to wait until Fun Fridays when we
Fun
bring back
Fridays
the old, you know, classics.
Fun Fridays.
So I'd rather
we like
do
to look back at some of the other shows we've made fun of to see if they've learned.
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
Yes. See if a year has taught them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Have you ever noticed changes?
One year, we got into the one guy's head so bad, he started, like, remember that one? Where he started going after the hole?
Yeah.
Does anyone else remember that? We got so into his head
because
we were speaking his language. He believed everything we were saying. It's like
right,
it finally got to him, and he started telling her shut up.
Started getting snippy with her.
Remember that?
Yes.
You're the one to blame.
Where was that? You remember?
I don't remember.
It's years ago at this point.
Yeah, people like it's such like an event in the lives of these shows. But for us, we do a different show every day.
Yeah, I don't even remember who we did yesterday.
So we don't remember any of these shows ever
right
existed.
Oh, no, I do remember. Ted and Amy in Syracuse. But the first day, I swear I don't remember.
Me neither.
Maine is just right now fucking in turmoil.
Oh, yeah.
The
yeah
entire state of Maine.
Someone's hacked into their Facebook
someone's
page.
Hacked. It might be anonymous.
You mean posted?
Something happened.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Something
disgusting
happened.
Disgusting.
And yes, and we got to take. Can we? Is there a way we can take that down so people don't see it? People don't see it. Just put it up like you usually have it. Who the fuck? No one sees it.
So they didn't sign off. They just went to.
I don't
like
know
best of
they had to have
for the day.
They had an emergency meeting. I would assume they're back on now.
Yeah.
You're right.
They decided how to handle it.
They take themselves too seriously. All right. More with Tom Papa and Amy Schumer.
All right.
Jim Norton's 911 call again.
Oh, I can't wait.
Just for you guys.
I can't wait.
Sirius XM. This is the Opie and Anthony Show.